Hello friends. With the basic knowledge about a C program, let's proceed with the next content, that is operators. Now, when we deal with a program will have various mathematical computations. And all these mathematical computations require one or the other operator. Before we start using them freely, before we start using them casually in our programs, let's understand the properties of these operators. Before we discuss about these operators, let's first make a classification of these operators. The entire set of C language operators are classified into three sections. And the classification is based on the number of inputs which they require for operations. A C language operators have something correlated to your mathematics. Some operators you might find very, very easy and they are in coordinates with your mathematics. But when it comes to a specific type of data, they might have a change here and there. We'll notice those changes and we'll proceed with our operations. So I said classification of these operators is based on a type called as number of data which they operate on. A set of operators might just use only one data. Operator which accepts only one data to operate, we call that as unary operator. A set of operators might accept two data, we call them as binary operators. There might be a set of data, three data which might be used for operators, we call that as ternary operator. So basically, classification is based on the number of data which are used for operation. Your binary operators are further classified based on their operation. All those operators which are related to your mathematics are arithmetic. All those operators which are related to assigning values are assignment operator. All those operators which are related to, say, relational and building a logical stuff are classified as relational logical. And C has got one unique section of operators called as bitwise operators. Now here, when you correlate these with your mathematics, you will find that arithmetic operators are the one which are common with your mathematics. But you are supposed to remember that they will differ as and when you use them with different types of data. Let's start with the first operator. Now, we'll have a study pattern differently. We'll have first the study of arithmetic operators, then we'll have a study of assignment operators, then we'll have a study of relational logical, then we'll have a study of bitwise operators, and then we'll go for ternary, and then we'll come back to unary. Basically, let's first wind up with those operators which are similar to your mathematics, and then we'll go ahead with the operators which are unique with C, that is operator which requires three data and operators which requires only one data. We'll see operators called as binary operators in the next section. Thank you. Hello friends. Let us deal with the first binary operator, that is arithmetic operators. Before we start using these operators, let's first identify what are the various arithmetic operators. The various arithmetic operators are plus for addition, minus for subtraction, asterisk is for multiplication, and slash is for a division operation. Now these are some of operators which are common with your mathematics, and we'll have one more operator called as percentage. We call this as a modulus operator. Can I use all these operators with any type of data? No. When it comes to operators, the five operators which I have listed out can be used with integer type of data. When it comes to float values, your operator list gets restricted to only the first four. And when it comes to characters, the operators get compressed to only the first two, that is addition and subtraction. So it means that I can use all these operators along with integer values. We can use only the first four operators with float values and first with characters. Let's identify the meaning of these operators. I have said plus as addition, minus as subtraction, asterisk as multiplication, slash as division, and percentage as modulus. Let me write these values. Now, if I ask you to identify these operators with some example, let's work with numbers and identify the meaning of these operators. Suppose if I had to work with integer values, with integers. So in this integer values, if I had to operate numbers, say 5u plus 2, 5u minus 2, 5u asterisk 2, 5u slash 2, 2 slash 5, 5u mod 2, and 2 mod 5. Let's write the result of these expressions at these places. No prize for guessing the first three answers. 5 plus 2 is 7, 5 minus 2 is 3, 5 asterisk 2 is 10. Definitely, you'll have some prize for guessing 5 slash 2. Mathematically, you might have said already, you might have got an answer as 2.5. But this is not true. The answer at this place is just 2, not 2.5. 2 by 5. Again, no prize for guessing this. You'll have answer as 0. Most of you might have got the answer as wrong. Now, you might wonder how I have written these answers as 2 or 2 by 5. In this case, when I write these numbers, the datas which I'm using at this place are integer. Rule of integer division operation says that when a numerator is an integer value, denominator is an integer value, the result is always an integer value. Remember this for the entire learning process of C language. When a numerator is integer value, denominator is integer value, the result is always an integer value. It means that 5 divided by 2 might mathematically yield us 2.5. But language constraints put this result as only 2, discard that particular 0.5. Does it mean that slash has not worked properly? No. Slash is still working properly. The division operation is still working properly. The only constraint which this has, that when numerator and denominator both are integer quantities, the result will be always an integer quantity. 5u mod 2. When you divide 5 by 2, what is the remainder which is left? The remainder which is left is 1. So 5u mod 2 is 1. Now when I say 2 mod 5, question comes, can I divide 2 by 5? No, we can't divide 2 by 5. In this case, the result is always 2. Because when I say A mod B, if A is less than B, the result is always A. These are two rules which are supposed to remember for your language. So it says for integer values, first ask, integer divided by integer is always an integer value. If I have A mod B as expression, and if I say that A is less than B, your result is always A. Remember this, int by int is integer, A mod B, A less than B, result is A itself. Now this is how it works with integer values. Suppose if I ask you to work with float values, let's work with float values. So I'll say float. Suppose if I have the number as 5.2 plus 1.8, 3.2 minus 0.2, 7.2 multiplied by 1.0, 8.5 by 1.0, or let me say 6.25 mod 5.0. Now, let's guess out these answers. 5.2 plus 1.8, never spell an answer as 7. Because when we add two float values, the result is going to be a float value, hence I should say it as 7.0, not 7. 3.2 minus 0.2 is 3.0. 7.2 multiplied by 1.0 is 7.2. 8.5 multiplied by 1.0 is 8.5. Did you thought of multiplying this? Did you thought of dividing this number? Never think, because this expression is an error. Why? Even though it might be convincing that 5 can be easily divided by 6.25, the remainder which might be left is 1.25, but never try this, because rule at this place says that modulus works only with float values. So modulus doesn't work with float values, it works with only integer values. So how do I work with integer numbers, with float values and these numbers? So integer values, all the 5, float with 4 and carry with 2. Now let's do an operation with character values. Suppose if I have, say, a character A is added with a 2, or a character A is added with, say, another character A. Don't conclude with the mathematics saying that it will add plus with plus, say 2A. No. What it does is, it converts these number back to some values called as ASCII values. Character A is converted to ASCII value called as 97, and character A is 65. 97 plus 65 is 162. But integer plus integer is integer, float plus float is float, hence character plus character is also character. Hence 162 will have some character. Similarly, you can carry out subtraction operation. So you can carry out addition or subtraction with what type of data? Only character values. With integers, we can have all 5. With float, we can have only 4. With character, we can have only first 2. But does it mean that we cannot have mixed data types? Yes, we can have mixed data types. Let's see how I work with mixed data types. Now, suppose if I have operators by name, say, a value, say 7 plus, say, 3.5. 7 is an integer quantity, 3.5 is a float quantity. Integer plus float plus operator denies to carry out the task. Plus says, I can't add integer and float. So in this case, one of these data had to be converted to the other type. So integer will be promoted to float, that is 7.0 plus 3.5, and the answer comes as 10.5, which is a float value. We call this particular conversion as a type casting or type conversion, which means an integer data is automatically promoted to a float value. So, an integer got promoted to this float value by the virtue of type casting or internal type casting. We have been saying that with mixed data type, always there is a type conversion, which means that a data of lower size is promoted to higher size. Hence, 7 is converted to 7.0. Probably, for us, it will not make big difference. But with system, it will make a big difference. Does it mean that these operators which I've used in integer, float, character and mixed data type, I'd used only one operator? What if I have multiple operators together? Can I have multiple operators in a single expression? Yes, we can have these multiple operators. Let's write one example with these multiple operators. If I write a random expression as, say, 2*3+4/, say, 2*9-3. I have asterisk, I have plus, I have slash, I have mod, I have minus. And the operators, the data which I have selected are of type integer. Now, how these operators are evaluated? These operators are evaluated as per the priority of these operators. Priority says that first level of priority, level 1, goes as asterisk, slash and percentage. Not necessarily they have to appear in this order. And level 2 of priority goes as addition and subtraction. Question comes, asterisk I have slash, I have mod. Have I listed these operators as per the appearance? No. They can have in any random order. Now I have asterisk, slash as well as mod. What need to be done first? Whenever you have an expression which has got two operators of same level priority, in that case, you have to look out for a term called as associativity. What do you mean by associativity? Associativity says that if two data are having same priority, how do I evaluate which one has to be evaluated first? The priority says left to write, which means that I'm supposed to evaluate, I'm supposed to scan the expression left to right. And if two operators have same priority, you have to evaluate the first one which appears at the beginning when you scan the expression from left to right. Let's try to eliminate one operator in one step. So here I'll have asterisk, slash and mod, all have equal priority, hence first will be multiplication. So I'll eliminate multiplication, I'll say 6 plus 4 slash 2 mod 9 minus 3. Now I'm left with plus slash mod. Again I have two operators, slash and mod, which are of same priority. Again look out for the associativity, that is left to right. Scan left to right and evaluate the expression. I have 4 slash 2. 4 by 2 is 2 mod 9 minus 3. Now I'm left with three operators in this, plus, mod and minus. Here I'll look out for priority because modulus has got higher priority over plus and minus. Hence we'll use modulus first. 6 plus A mod B. Just now we concluded that A mod B. If A is less than B, the result is always A. Yes, you got it right. 2 mod 9 is 2 minus 3. 6 plus 2 minus 3. I have plus and minus. Again, plus and minus have got same priority. Hence, what we'll do now? You'll again look out for associativity. Left to right. Start evaluating the expression. 6 plus 2 is 8 minus 3. And 8 minus 3 is 5. The entire expression got reduced to this particular 5 by the virtue of its priority and associativity. So we can conclude that there are 5 arithmetic operators: addition, subtraction, multiplication, division and modulus. Priority classified into 2 levels: multiplication, division and modulus go into the higher priority, addition, subtraction to the lower priority. And associativity will tell us if two operators have same priority, which one need to be evaluated first. Thank you.